Today is going to be a very productive day. You have no school, no work, no family obligations, just study, study, study. You're so excited, you sit down and what do? Do I study biology or do I do cars practice? Videos, books, so many options. Where to even begin? I personally like to create my plan for the day the night before or in the morning before coffee so I know exactly what to do. But even once you get started, you're moving along and suddenly, uh-oh, what's for dinner? Oh, I have this in the freezer. If I defrost it, then I cook it. We'll be ready when the baby is awake. Oh, baby, I need to call the pediatrician. And suddenly your productivity is gone. In this Lay for Side video, I'm going to share my ADHD trifecta. Three things that are individually helpful, but together is my secret for staying focused despite ADHD. Number one, the Pomodoro. No, I'm not talking tomatoes. The Pomodoro technique was named for a tomato-shaped kitchen timer and is all about staying focused for a specific amount of time. The idea here is to focus for a short burst and then take a break. If you're working on a topic you love, it's very easy to stay focused. But what if you're on fluids in physics or spectroscopy in organic chemistry and you just can't study for another second? If that timer says just 5 more minutes, it's easy enough to push yourself because it's not indefinite. It's just 5 more minutes. And at layforside.com/pomodoro, link below, I show you how to apply this to MCAT studying or any studying. And if, while your timer is going, something comes up, that brings us to number two. But first, give this video a thumbs up, like and subscribe so you don't miss out on any new videos, and then we talk about the distraction list or my personal sanity savior. To understand ADHD, I want you to imagine that you're sitting in a room just lined with televisions. Every single one has a different program with audio coming out, and you're trying to focus on just one. Are you able to tune the rest out? Maybe if you're very focused, but if you're tired, distracted, or something comes up, suddenly you start to look at everything and whatever was going on in front of you, gone. So I keep a list nearby, and this could be anything, a notebook, a whiteboard, envelope from recent bills, anything. And while I'm working, while you're studying, if something pops up, just write it on your distraction list. You can keep going because you know that whatever that thing was, you're going to see it in a few minutes. But for right now, you have to stay focused. Once your focus block is over and you have a break, go back to your distraction list and make a plan for whatever it is that has to get addressed, knowing that your studying is done. Last but not least, number three, the accountability timer. I started using Toggl back in 2017 and it has been a game changer. You don't want to track everything, but if you're working on study-related tasks, for example, studying, reading, watching, practicing, have a timer tracking exactly what you're doing and only what you're doing. If somebody comes in to talk to you, if you have to go to the bathroom, if any kind of distraction comes up, pause the timer, take care of what you're taking care of, or put it on your distraction list, and then go back to studying with the timer on. Seeing those numbers on the timer can be eye-opening. If you know you can study for 3 hours after work and you feel like you're not getting anything done, you look at that timer and you see, oh, I only studied for 45 minutes. Of course you didn't get through a lot. You felt that chapter took forever? Well, how long did it actually take? Not how much time you sat there trying to study, but how much time was actual studying as opposed to talking to your friend, going on social media, thinking about something else that isn't study related. For me, it's also about gamification. If I have a timer running, because yes, Toggl's running for me right now, I won't do anything else. Because the timer is going and I will do whatever necessary not to pause that timer until I'm done. So how does Toggl work and specifically, how do you set it up for MCAT studying? First, make sure to give this video a thumbs up, like and subscribe and hit that bell notification icon so you don't miss out on any new videos. Then see the link below or go to layforside.com/toggl where I walk you through step-by-step how to set it up for the MCAT. The link again is layforside.com/toggl, no E.